Well, hello my friend and welcome to my channel. Today I'm part of a collaboration for Summer Cravings. I was invited by Chris Fawn. I've started this manicure off with Miltique's Formula 2 and the Crayola Insta-Dry in the color Wild Strawberry. And I'm going to be using this China Glaze Riveting as a topper. And I'm going to top it off with Posh Top Coat. But as I get started, I do realize that I'm going to need another polish, and I'll let you know about that one here in a minute. I'm doing a base coat of this beautiful red from the Crayola collection. I love these polishes. They're one coat polishes and they really go on nice and smooth. Really do love these. Gonna probably wish I'd bought more. So we've got the coat of that down. And I'm gonna do a little bit of cleanup because I clean up as I go along. Just bothers me if I don't. And there we go, all cleaned up, beautiful red. And now I'm gonna apply a very thin layer of this China Glaze Riveting, and it's kind of orangey. And that's when I realized, okay, this is not looking watermelon-y. So I'm gonna use Lolly Jolly from L'Oreal. It's kind of a jelly. And I'm just going to go over this so that the sparkle still shows through, but it's a little more red than orange. Got to break out Woody and do a little bit of cleanup. There we go. Liking it so far. I'm going to top this off with some Posh Top Coat to get it to dry down so that I can do some stamping. And to be honest with you, this right here alone is just a beautiful manicure. Loving it. I'm going to be using this You Are Beautiful 04 Stampin' Plate today, and the Sally Hansen Granny Smith Apple, and Bundle Monster Straight Up Black, and my Mo-U Scraper, and my Bundle Monster Monocle Stamper. Now I'm going in and I'm swiping the green over the rind and the black over where the seeds will be. And I'm thinking this is going to work out really nice, but it doesn't. The green doesn't want to stick, so I'm going to try just doing it with just the green. I'm trying to restick. Nope. And some more trying of the green. And it's too thin. It's just too thin and too, it's not looking like a watermelon. It's looking a little crazy. So I'm just going to go in with the brush and kind of do a little green swipe on my tips. I've just decided that's going to be the easiest way to do this. So now I'm just going to focus on stamping the seeds on the rest of my nails. Using my little tape to clean up the excess. I'm going to plop these seeds on. Clean that plate off and do it again. There we go. So far I'm just really enjoying this one. It's going to be pretty to wear. But when I think of summer, I always, always think of watermelon. I don't know what it is about summer, but I crave watermelon, and it's the best time of year to find a really sweet, good watermelon. We've got people that sell them on the side of the road everywhere. You just pull over and buy you a melon. And it also gets so hot, and watermelon is just one of those nice little treats. So we're going to try doing the green again for the stripes. And it's going, but it's just not enough. It's not enough for me. So I'm going to go in again and just swipe the tips a little bit with the brush from the polish. And I'm not being super duper neat about this, as you can see. But I'm going to get the effect I want. Sometimes that's just what we have to do, painting our nails. We just have to go with it and do what we can to make it work. And for me today, this is working. And before I forget, I want to mention it again. This is a collab, Summer Cravings collab. I will have a link down below for everybody involved in this collab. And I would love for you to go and watch their videos, give them a thumbs up, and if you're not already subscribed to their channel, give them a look around. Go look around on their channel, watch some of their older videos, and if you like what you see, click that subscribe button and the notification button so you know when they upload. So we're going to go in and do a little bit of cleanup with some masking tape. Get some of that extra stamping polish off of my fingers before we head on to the top coating. But I wanted to make this a juicy looking watermelon, so that's why I wanted that little sparkle jumping out from underneath. And there we go. We're going to do our final cleanup with our Sonia Kushak's Tools No. 27 brush and some acetone, and just get up any little stray bits, tidy it up just a little bit, making quick work of it. There we go. Almost done with the cleanup. Yay! So there we have it. I'm going to top this one off with some Posh Top Coat. Seal my design in. There we go. Loving it. Got to break out Woody again and do a little bit more cleanup. And there is my manicure. Here is my swatch photo. I hope you enjoyed this one. Please leave me a comment down below and let me know what you think about it. That is all I have for you today. Thanks for watching, and until next time, be good to yourself. Talk to you soon. Bye.